opening the door and then you run out. It's a given. It's a give me. Hello. Oh, hi. Come on, Twix. Hello. Oh, see? They come right back in. No biggie. And then they go right back out. Want to go see Daddy? I missed my babies today. We just finished dinner and the boys were crying. Hold on. And I was like, I should go get them. And then Catherine wrote, "Don't worry, boys, Mama's gonna be there in a minute." So true. Early. Chilly in here. He's gonna say hang out for a little bit. Okay, let's leave her alone. Good job, Twix. Yes, that's Penny with the boys. That's my little Pen. She desperately wants to be best friends with them. She's currently watching us watch us on TV, I guess. Yeah, I brought a book. Yes. No, I'm not going to read any bedtime stories. I started my new advanced feline training class, and this is the textbook. Behavior problems of the dog and cat. So obviously we're just going to focus in on the cat part, and I was supposed to do a ton of reading today, and that didn't happen because I was very tired from Dorian keeping us up. So I was thinking maybe I can get some reading done in here, in theory. Yes, they were invited out to go see Dad. And then they ran back in and then ran back out to the master. Are you harassing her? Come here. Oh,
for us, Penny.
I missed it. Leave Penny alone. Ideally, I'd like to get these guys comfortable around Penny. I think we found out, obviously, yesterday the governor extended our stay-at-home order until May 4th. So these guys will be with us through the duration and most likely till about June-ish. So that's a long time, which we're very happy about. But the reality is these guys are almost 8 months old. And so although the room in theory looks big, it's just a standard, I think it's 10 by 11. And we don't want these guys getting too cooped up. So there might be periods of time that we let them out, get their energy out. Someone, Helen has cat allergy. Has there been clicker training today? Yes, this morning. Oh, Lizzie, sorry, answered that. They did very well. We'll do it again tonight, just after 11. Trying is the key word to do at 11 a.m. and 11 p.m.-ish time frame. Yes, hopefully more catio visits. That would be great for them. He sees himself on TV. Doing okay, Penny? Dad's gonna come in a little bit, and when that happens, I'll scoop litters.
Oh. Let's do your kittens.
Nope. Everything was a success?
Yep.
Twixie.
I bought a extra pillow. Oh, look. I got this for my birthday a couple of years ago. It goes on our couch. So I thought it'd be good for the room so Dad can have something to lay back on. Not there, though.
Are you singing for your pupils?
Look at the tails. They had a few little swatty swats. Did you see?
I was occupied.
Oh, how are the cookies going? I should take a picture. Well,
we put the batter in the fridge overnight as requested by the, recommended by the instructions, but it had a lot of M&Ms in it. And so it was impossible to manage as is because the M&Ms were frozen. It just broke off into chunks. We had to heat it up again and roll it into balls.
Well, heat it up, we just sat in a hot water bath. So it's, they're in the fridge in balls. And after Chris comes home, I think we were gonna cook them. Yes, so Valerie says it will be hard to let them go when the time comes. Yes, because they're my little babies right now.
It's always hard. That's how you know you did the job right. Because we're supposed, in order to make them the best possible kitties to be adopted, we have to fall in love with them. We have to show them what it's like to have people loving them. Because they're like little kids. They know when someone's faking. Who's rubbing up against their straw? Who's doing an Eddie?
Eddie likes to rub on John's toothbrush. We've since solved it, so that's not sitting out. But and I wouldn't move it away from Eddie.
She pointed at it, and it's like, John, look! I was like in bed, barely awake, and I look over, and it's like, she's just laughing. It's like, stop him already! Stop him! Don't worry, Twix. One day.
Yeah, tomorrow.
Should we tell them?
I kind of mentioned it, but you can talk about it.
Okay. We're trying to get the boys used to our cats and our cats used to the boys because they're likely going to be here for a couple more months due to the COVID lockdown and Homeward Pet staying closed due to that. If they were younger, like what I normally foster, it'd be fine if they were in here the whole time. But these guys are 7, almost 8 months old, and this room is too small for them, as evident by all the sleeping. They get bored. So once we do a week of acclimation with our existing kitties.
Oh, yeah.
A week.
I don't.
Plus or minus.
They already are fine when they run out the door. They don't go very far. Yeah. They know the drill.
I know. I say a week because that's what I like, but like plus or minus days. But we're going to let them out. And we're going to leave the door open. But the cam will stay on. You guys tend to sit here and watch them sleeping all day and chatting. You still have the room to watch, and occasionally with. You will see our cats come in here. Darn will come in here and lay and take a nap on the floor. That's what he used to do before we started fostering. And you may even see Trillian.
No, you won't see Trillian.
Yeah, probably not. But we're still gonna feed the boys in here.
Probably at night they would stay in here.
Yeah.
Overnight. Hi. I mean, that's in theory, right? We don't know what's going to happen. That's a theory and what we'd like to go to.
Yeah.
But B does have some issues in general. So that will all be dependent on B.
If the dynamic in our house is like totally tossed up in the air because these guys are let free, then they'll have to come back in here. But best case scenario, they'll be roaming free. You guys will still be able to catch Kitty coming in here.
Penny Marie. Okay.
You see, this is sort of the thing that we're trying to get them used to seeing other kitties.
He's gonna launch up to her. So, Ghosty says we'll have to do a cookie intervention once people can mix and mingle. Beep Beep says the colors bleed? Is that question mark? I don't know what that means.
The color and the M&Ms.
But yeah, okay. I don't know. Let her be.
They melt, so they'll bleach in.
Not watching.
Yes, Lizzie, they better be good after this. We have been taste testing, if we were honest.
We probably got worms now, sis.
At least we don't have salmonella.
It will be like a trail cam waiting for a kitty to wander by. In theory.
I probably will say things like, enjoy the room, have a nice day. Because I've been known to modify the exit quote based on circumstance.
Do you have to have a couple more minutes and you're going to leave?
Yeah, I'm watching the time.
Okay, I'm going to go and scoop that, okay?
Okay.
I'll probably go downstairs and read down there.
Oh, he already misses you.
I know, he loves me.
Zuko's by the door. She's going to scoop out there first. So. Look how long he is. His butt's against my tummy and he's like past my knee. Do I have battery-operated toys that we can leave in the room? Well, we do have some cat toys. We had one in here this morning, and they seem to both like it.
Coming in.
Zuko's right behind the door.
You, and that's an exit.
She's like, stop, don't go.
What was I going to say?
Hi, Wendy. And you want to open the door next time? Mm-hmm.
Twix is trying to open the door.
Excuse me, buddy.
I'll come back.
I'll bring one of the... damn it.
You make it so much harder than it has to be.
Yeah, Nikki is not a fan of the boys.
Oh my god, look how you're holding them. Well, because they came charging on at her, probably.
Twix was in there all pushed up.
There's something I was going to say, now I don't remember. Oh, you know that's Penny's favorite game, so... We have had Penny... We timed Penny. She walked out for what?
She played with it for like 2 hours straight.
Not more.
This is one of the battery operated toys that we have. And the, whatever the clip is going on, I don't know what happened to it.
Oh, I see it over here. Did you just add the escape to the button?
No, I haven't pushed both buttons yet.
You were supposed to, the point of me doing it was
swap. My hands were full.
I told you I was coming in.
This morning they pushed it up against the wall so it was making that noise nonstop.
Okay, buddy. Dad's going to get upset if I let you go out one more time.
Pretty sure these guys would be adopted before they even available for. Well, they'll be pre-adopted, I guess. and so I'm waiting for them to reach the shelter. Clip is just to keep it from the cover from coming off so easy.
You stay back. Come on. You stay back. No. All right.
He made it to the living room and went around the couch, sipped in front, the tail up the whole time. Coming in, Penny. Coming in, Penny? Tired already. Don't try to kill it.
Come on.
Quick like a bunny. You gotta come in now or don't come in at all.
Chicken fish. I love. She says, wait, stuff gets put in cupboards instead of randomly squished into the shelf. I love it. Yep, a whole new world John's living. Happens in the house, too. Yeah, there's yes. MM says, I respect the optimism of bringing in the book. I'd like to be able to read it. But I also didn't want to hear them crying, so it was a toss up. And then we didn't take the water out, so I had to come in anyway. So the whole thing. Don't chew it, please. Rand asks, who says who's visiting? My name is Jessica, and I am John's fiancée. And Penny Murray is up on the shelf or the window. After Penny and I leave the room most nights, and she's just up here watching them play, we go downstairs and she insists that we play because she didn't get a chance to play. She's not big of a talker, but when she wants something, she has this little old lady meow. She's like, it's my turn, Mom. She's only two. Yes, Penny does love her windowsills. And there's lots of them in this house, so it's awesome. You can't see, but Trix is in the tunnel. Okay, gotta let go, Penny. She stole your feather. What are you guys gonna do about it? Thank you.
No, no. Okay. This thing is getting beat up. Okay, Penny. No, you're gonna break it.
Kill this. We got it. Oopsies, are you okay? Hit your head. You guys are done. time to rest for a little bit. I put cat TV on for them. I'm in the kitten room. I'm in here.
Okay. Are you? Why is there a difference?
Because I was playing and I pushed it out. Zuko, leave Penny alone. Zuko. Zuko. Good boy. Good job, Penny. Zuko, Zuko, come. Good boy. Get over here. Please don't bug her. She's being very good. Can you come in here? Come in here. Come on. Zuko, good boy. You gonna come on my lap? What's going on? Zuko. I mean, Twix. 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 I don't want to have to get up. There we go.
And now I'm going to have to get up. Oops, sorry, Penny. That was my bed. Ready, Pen? Oh, Jesus. Zuko, don't run, Penny. Okay, it's time for you to go. Did they get you? Let me see your face. You okay? Mommy loves you. You gotta be nice to the girls. It's not nice. I'm gonna get a date sometime. You can't do that. Your butt stinks. Did you guys just fart?
Twix. What? The last paragraph of my first part of the reading says, some feline vocalizations, particularly purring and meowing, can very easily turn into a way to get the owner's attention for food, for access to preferred area. Thus, it is important for the owner not to pay attention to those vocalizations. Nevertheless, excessive vocalization itself can be a sign of a behavioral problem. In some cases, an indication of a underlying state of stress. Anyway, are you trying to manipulate me? Are you? You do a good job. You guys gonna continue to watch the birdies and the squirrels? Oh, don't be so dramatic. Ooh, it's going to be 7 degrees warmer tomorrow. Yes, it is. Oh, yeah. Can you be nice to Penny? Please. I'm gonna go say hi to Daddy. You can give him a heart attack.
We'll be back in a second.
You found the bird toy. Zuko is downstairs and supervised by Jess. Oops, sounds like she's on her way up. Zuko found the bird toy, Twix.
Yep.
He was dragging it out of Chris. It was like partially underneath Chris's door, and he was dragging it out.
So, Zuko inspected all downstairs, and he went to the laundry room, and he went to go in, and he went like that. And Ruthie was tucked in as tight as can be, but they could still smell each other. And then Ruthie started hissing from inside the cocoon. He did very, very good. Are we going to do... So you guys are going to finish your episode?
Yeah.
Okay, and then we'll... Should I put the cookies in the oven?
Sure.
And then we'll come back in and do cooker training and say goodnight.
Okay.
Wait. I want to... It's going to be an issue when we leave.
I know, I'm just hiding this. Yeah, don't look up there.
Oh, look, here's a Dorian.
Just what we need.
He's been sleeping all day long.
Maybe he should sleep in here. So we can sleep. Hey. Diffused him. Dorian's getting smacked from left and right around here. He just stands still, just waiting for it to end. Alrighty, we'll be back in a little bit for clicker training, but for now, enjoy the kittens. Have a nice day.